to my YouTube channel. First off, I just want to say thank you guys so much for all the subscribing and the liking and commenting. I really appreciate it, and everybody has shown me so much love, so it means the world, and thank you so much. Secondly, I just wanted to say that I wanted to create this video because I want to help people that are currently going through what I went through for a long time. And I felt like I didn't have any answers or anybody to relate to. So yeah, this is why I'm creating these videos and this video specifically. But anyways, I am gonna set my camera up at a different angle so I can talk about this a little easier. Yeah, so here we go. Okay, so I've got my tea. I'm just gonna like cozy up on the couch here and talk with you guys about this. I'm gonna basically like start from the beginning. I walked into work in September of 2018 and I kind of felt sick. And I hadn't been sick in like a really, really, really long time. So for me to say that I was sick really meant a lot because I'd never get sick. So I was just like, man, I don't feel good. I was talking to my coworker and I was like, I kind of feel like I have a fever. And she was like, oh no, do you feel like you have the flu or something? And I was like, maybe. My throat kind of hurts. I'm kind of nauseous. She's like, oh man, you need to go to the doctor. I'll send you home. Go to the doctor. So I went to the doctor and they tested me for the flu and it came back negative. And so they asked me, have you ever had strep throat? And I was like, no, I've actually never had it. And they're like, wow, that surprises me. Usually people have it as a kid. And I was like, no, I've never had it before. They're like, well, we think that's what you have. We're gonna test you for it. So they tested me for it and it came back positive. And I was like, oh no, what is strep? Like I don't know what to do. She's like, oh, it's not a big deal. Like I said, kids are usually the ones to get it, but we'll just prescribe these antibiotics to you and you'll get over it pretty quickly. And I said, okay, cool. So I took the antibiotics, which was amoxicillin. That's usually the one that they prescribe to you. So I took them, I think it was 10 days worth of antibiotics. I think that's what they said to do. So I did that. And yeah, I went on with my life and everything was fine. And then a month and a half later, I started to feel sick again. So this was November. And I was like, oh no, maybe I have the flu because somebody at my work had the flu and I had been in contact with them. So I was like, oh, dang it, I totally have the flu. I went to the doctor, tested me for the flu, came back negative, and then they tested me for strep and it came back positive. And I was like, oh no, I just had this. I wonder if that's like weird. I wonder if I'm okay. So I talked to the doctor about it and she was like, oh, you know, it's fine. Sometimes it just doesn't kill it off the first time. And I was like, well, I took all the antibiotics. And she's like, no, I know. Sometimes people get it twice, but you'll be fine. And I was like, okay. And I took the antibiotics again and the 10 days worth, and I was fine. You know, I had a little nausea, but I figured that that was from the antibiotics. Like that was a side effect or whatever. I was like, okay, I'll be fine. And then, this is like such a long story, but the day after Christmas, I started feeling sick again. And I was like, okay, this better not be strep or I'm gonna scream. So you guys, literally, I went to the doctor and they tested me for strep and it came back positive once again. And I was just like, okay, something is going on. This can't be normal to have strep this many times in like a short amount of time. And I told the doctor that and I was like, you know, I expressed this concern to the last doctor that I saw and had gotten strep, you know, twice, but this is the third time. Should I be worried? She was like, no, no, you'll be fine. Did you take the full 10 days worth? And I was like, yes, I did that both times. And she was like, you should be fine. Kids sometimes get recurring strep too and they have to get their tonsils out. And I was like, okay, well, I don't wanna get my tonsils out. No, that doesn't sound fun. So I was like, what can I do to make sure I don't have to get my tonsils taken out? And the doctor was like, well, you know, take the antibiotics again and make sure you're just drinking a lot of fluids, and make sure you're taking vitamin C and staying up on like all of your vitamins, and just build your immune system up. That's what she told me. So I was like, okay, I'll be sure to do that. So I just got, I don't know, like vitamin C capsules from the store. I didn't know what I was doing. I just got a bunch of vitamins and started taking them. And I was like, man, I really hope this works. I really hope I don't get strep again. And so I took the antibiotics again, the full round of it. And on the 9th day, I started to have that nausea thing again. I was like, dang it, maybe I'm not eating enough with the antibiotics. But I was like, no, I am eating full meals with my, when I'm taking it. And so I was like, that can't be it. But I was like, whatever, if it goes away when the antibiotics are done, then I'll be fine. Because that's what happened last time. So, finished the antibiotics and went on. And I literally kept having nausea. Not even when I would eat, just any time of the day, I would just get nauseous. And I was like, okay, this is kind of weird. Why do I still feel like this? And I told my husband, maybe I have a stomach bug. And he's like, yeah, you know, maybe that's it, because your immune system's kind of low because of the antibiotics. And I was like, okay, that's it, you know. So I just kind of accepted that fact. I have a stomach bug, you know. And so then the nausea kept getting worse and worse. And it got to the point where I was like, I'm sorry if this is TMI, but I was like dry heaving after I would eat. I was literally just like, I cannot eat this. It's literally making me nauseous, even just smelling it. And I just didn't know what was going on. And then this is when it started getting really, really bad. I kept getting stomach pain now. So I was getting nauseous and I got stomach pain after every single meal that I would eat. And the pain progressively got worse. At first it was just like a little tummy ache, but then it turned into like severe throbbing pain. And I had to cut out everything. I literally only ate oatmeal and bread and bananas and rice and bone broth, and that was it. That was literally all I could eat and could stand. So I told Jack, I was like, this isn't normal. I can't continue eating like this because I feel like I'm gonna develop another issue or something. And he was like, I totally agree with you. You need to go see an actual doctor. So I wanted to kind of heal it naturally. I didn't really want to take medication or anything. So I went to kind of more of a natural doctor, and she was very concerned. And she said, you need to be taking a strong, strong, strong probiotic. And you need to also be taking, because I described the digestive thing. She's like, you need to be taking omeprazole and Zofran, which the Zofran was for nausea and the omeprazole was for acid reduction. And I was like, oh, I don't know about the acid one, because I'm literally already having digestive problems. Like, do I need acid in my stomach to digest food? And so I decided not to take the omeprazole or the Zofran, because I was like, I don't want to put another medication in my body. And so I did a ton of research, and I was like, man, I don't know really what to do at this point. She ordered for me to take a GI map test, and she also wanted me to go to a gastroenterologist to get a endoscopy done, which is a little tube with a camera on the end of it that goes down your stomach and looks at everything to make sure it's okay. But I was like, I can't. I did a lot of research and I was like, man, I can't do this. I can't do it with medicine. I just can't. So I was kind of back to square one after I decided not to take the omeprazole and Zofran. I was taking the probiotic because I wanted to build the good bacteria back in my stomach, but I was like, not taking the medication. So I just had to do more and more and more research. And I came across this guy His name is Medical Medium on Instagram. I came across him and I started just reading through all of these stories about how his protocols have healed people from things like what I was going through, recurring strep and digestive issues and like all kinds of stuff. And I was like, maybe this will work for me. Maybe I should try this out because I've kind of tried other things, you know, and I don't want to try medication. I feel like that could just make it worse and cause other things to happen. I decided to, you know, follow some of his protocols, and I got his book. It's like Life Healing Foods or Life Changing Foods or something. I'll link it below so you can see it. But I just made a list of every single symptom that I had, and I read through the book and literally wrote down every single food that he said to eat for those symptoms. And I was like, okay, like I'm getting on the uphill here, I can do this. So one of the things that he said to do was to drink celery juice. And I know like that sounds really gross, but it sounded gross to me too. But I was like, hey, if this works, I'm gonna do it. It's healed other people, and so I think it can heal me too. And I did it. I started drinking celery juice, and I had to start out with like a very, very low ounce of celery juice. I literally did like an ounce. I started out with that low. It was so crazy. And the first time I drank it, I was just like, oh, this kind of hurts my stomach. Yeah, an ounce of celery juice hurt my stomach. But I gotta stick with it because I think this can really work for me. And he explains that celery juice will make you go through a detox process. So you might get better before, or you might get worse before you get better. And I was like, okay, you know, it's not gonna be a Band-Aid. You know, it's not gonna be a medication that will just be a Band-Aid. This is something that will heal me from the inside out and actually work. And I was just believing all of this, you know? So I literally did the celery juice thing, you guys. And I will tell you right now, I think that is the main thing that healed me. I also switched up my diet. I went completely plant-based and I cut out gluten, I cut out dairy, I cut out meat, I did all that. I literally just ate like spinach and avocados and bananas and celery and all kinds of stuff, like literally all the fruits and vegetables you could think of. I literally ate just that, and I didn't go out to eat for 4 months straight. Yeah, 4 months. I literally ate at home every single day because A, I didn't trust what people use in their foods at restaurants. Like, I don't know if there's pesticides on stuff. I don't know if they're using canola oil or coconut oil. Like, I just didn't know what they were using. So I was like, in order for me to heal properly, I'm gonna have to know exactly what's going in my body and what's working and what's not working. And the only way to do that was to eat at home. And then, you know, I was like a month into it, and I started increasing my ounces of celery juice that I was drinking every morning. So I started out with literally like an ounce or two and just kept increasing it. And I got up to 16 ounces and I was like, this is amazing. I just started to feel so much better. I was like, man, I am really on the uphill. This is working. And then I got strep 2 more times after that. And I was like, are you joking me? I thought I did all this work for nothing, but I read that strep, it can take a very long time to get out of your system, especially like if you were taking antibiotics and your immune system was shot. I knew that it was probably gonna happen again, and it did twice. And I decided not to take the antibiotics when I got strep again, because I figured out I was allergic to the antibiotics, and that's what caused all of these digestive issues. And I was like, I can't take those antibiotics again. Like, it's so, so bad for you. And I was scared when I decided not to take them because they said strep can kill you. It can literally kill you. And I was like, I have to make sure that I you know, do everything possible to not die. I know that's kind of morbid, but I was just like, I've got to be super strict about my supplements. I've got to take everything that I've learned. And so I did like oregano oil, I did zinc, I made my own elderberry syrup and I drank that. I did juicing, I continued doing celery juice every single day. I increased my ounces to like 30 ounces during that time when I had strep, because I was like, get it out. And celery juice specifically will kill off strep. I read that in his books. And so I was just like, let's get all the celery juice possible in me. So I literally did so much celery juice and continued to eat vegan. And it killed it off, you guys. It seriously killed it off. And I'm not suggesting that you do this, because it's a risk, and everybody's bodies are different and react differently. And it was really, really scary. But I just really was strict about it. I really made sure that, you know, I was gonna be okay. And if I ever did get to a point, I told myself, if I ever get to a point where I feel like I need to go to the ER or anything, I would definitely go, but I never got to that point. My fever never got high enough and I was okay. My husband also monitored me. He was like, I'm gonna make sure that you're doing okay. He was so good in that time. But yeah, I literally did completely fine. I had no issues. And I actually got over strep faster than when I took the antibiotics. It was so weird, and I felt better too. The antibiotics made me feel kind of when I was taking it, and I didn't feel that way this time. I'm so thankful that I like learned everything and did so much research. And I'm very proud to say that I have not had strep in a whole year, which is crazy. And I have also not had any stomach issues in like also a year. It's been so long. It's just so crazy to say that, because I was in such a low place. I didn't know that I would be healed from my stomach issues, because it got so bad, you know? I couldn't sleep well, I had so much inflammation, and I just thought I'm gonna be like this for the rest of my life, and I'm not. I'm here, and I'm healed, and I want you guys to heal too. That's the reason why I made this video. I'm here for anybody that's going through that. I know it feels so lonely, and it feels like you're never gonna get better. But I'm telling you, it is possible to heal and it's possible to feel better. And if anybody has any questions at all, I'd be completely happy to answer them for you. I'd actually like love to answer them for you. I'm here to talk about this stuff, and I'll be creating more videos about what supplements I have in my cabinet that I use every day now, and how I'm staying on top of my routine. But yeah. You guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I know it was really long, but I am so glad to be talking about this now. I'm very grateful for everything, and I think everything happens for a reason. And I'm not saying that I'm happy that I got sick or anything like that, but it's opened my eyes to a whole new world. I'm a lot happier, and I'm healthier, and my lifestyle is so much better. And so for that, I'm grateful for sure. But yeah, thank you again, and don't forget to like and comment and subscribe. I'll be coming out with more content soon, and I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your week.